Probably some of the smartest people on the planet, because they can do anything. I've heard them referred to as idiots more times than I'd like to remember. I was a merchant seaman as well as a fisherman and a carpenter, and I'm a tractor trailer technician by trade. You know, we're all capable of doing many other jobs. I was 9 when I started, and I'm 60 now. If you're independent, you can pretty much do what you want to do. If you want to go to work, you go, and if you don't, you don't. You can earn a fair living at it, so. I make about the same every year. I gross about $120,000.
I think most of us like it because of the fact that there's something different every time. It's like a birthday present. You're opening up something you don't know what you're gonna have. You might come up with 30 lobsters, you might come up with 0. You just never know. As you can see, it's not that great. It's gonna be hard pressed to get 8 lobsters. Most I've seen in a trap, just lobsters in general, was like 60. That was several years ago. We got them so early and so many that we flooded the market. Those guys are building $1 million boats and engines and big boats, and they're all offshore fishermen, but right now they're not doing so good either. So they got these big payments, and there's not a whole lot of lobsters to be, you know, caught to pay for them. I mean, there's always gonna be lobsters here. It's who's ever gonna manage their money better is gonna be the one staying around.
Oh, it's just fun, you know. You're working them all year and then you get a day to play, so. Just go out and try and beat the other guy. People come from hundreds of miles, you know, to see the boat races.
You get to go hang out with your friends and drink beer and go fast. And it's so fun. We don't go for the prizes, we just go for the glory. Bragging rights, really.
The boat racing for the coast of Maine started here. To claim the title world's fastest, you gotta come here. You don't win it anywhere else on the coast. It started out with competition between the boat builders. That's what started it.
My great-grandfather used to build rum luggers, running bulls during the Prohibition.
He had 60-foot boats that do 40 knots back then.
About in the 30s, they started lobster boat racing. It really got big, about 75 I ran them. Well, anyway, they grew from 5-horse engines, 10-horse engines, to 45-footers with 1,200-horse diesels in them. I'm in Class B, under 375 cubic inch. My engine's 359, or maybe more, I don't know. I should win 3 races. I guess the screws that hold the plank on backed off, and it allowed the plank to separate. And we was probably going about close to 40 miles an hour, and all that water blew in before I realized we were sinking. I've done everything with this boat but burn it. That's just part of racing. Sometimes you blow up an engine, I just happen to sink a boat.
This is the down east version of tailgating. This is our version of it right here. And we do it on the water in boats. You got a lobster boat doing 50, 60 miles an hour. That's an accomplishment. That's what that is.
We're here, boys.
Woo-hoo! We're pumped. We gotta give them a show.
Yeah.
hard to jump from that to this. You know, you're going 60 and then you can go to back down to 25. Some races have raffles. Some give you first place prizes, second, third. I guess Scania is introducing a new motor, so they're gonna have an open bar.
Just trying to keep tradition, I guess, more alive. But it's been going on for, well, like I said, a lot longer than I have been here.
To me, it's family. That's just the way of life. It's the way it's always been. We could give you guys a lobster supper if you wanted it. We can take these lobsters I catch in and go boil them up, and you can have them for supper if you'd like. That's about as good as it gets. Yeah. Trust me.